Hello, this is Sjoerd de Vries, and I want to demonstrate you how to change your font type in case you want to have a different font in your documents and your published output. First you start with your template, so an administrator with the appropriate rights open the template and go to the styles section. And in the styles section you have different sections for example default text, where you can have a specific font type, or document title. Well, in case you need huge changes, for example, change the default font from Arial to Calibri, then it might be useful to go to the bulk style change, where you actually can load the style, the current style, and then apply it for a lot of the same. Then you can apply it at once, so you can change directly a specific font type. Okay, so that's not hard. You just click on select and select different font, and you just check in your template, and that's it. The next step would be that you check on the client who has this uPerform that he actually has this font, because else it will not be visible when editing the simulations and publish it locally. On a Windows 7 machine, it's easy to just type in fonts, and you will see here the fonts folder, and you can see here the font family, and the font family is Calibri. So I just browse to Calibri here, and just to be sure, so it's installed on my machine, I just copy it to be able to send it to others. Let's go to my desktop. I have fonts folder here. You always have to paste it in a specific folder if you copy it directly from the system folder in Windows 7, because all these TTF files, which are the different specific fonts, and this is the whole font family, are combined together. So if you just save it somewhere in a folder, it will actually, yeah, it looks like an unpacking a zipped file. And you can copy this further. Okay, so I now have my template correct, and I checked it with the local machine. The next thing you have to check, of course, if it's also available on the server, because if you publish it, it will actually take that fonts from the server. So you have to go to the application server, and you have to make sure that you copy the fonts to the server desktop. So there are several ways to do that. One way is just to have remote desktop connection, where you select your local resources, make the clipboard option available, and also make sure that you check the drives, also you cannot copy it from the C drive, and you just connect. Okay, so I'll have my Dex external server here, and now I can really just copy this folder. Okay, it's been copied now. On a Windows 2008 server, it's easy, you just double click on the file, and then you have an installation option. However, this button install is not available on the Windows 2003 server. So on the Windows 3 server, it works a little bit different. You just go to your folder with your fonts, or my computer, C, Windows, and then you search for the fonts. And you just simply copied these files into this one. I already did that. I don't do it again. On a Windows 3 server, I'm not sure if this is also applying for 2008 or 2012 servers, but on the Windows 3 server, you have to restart the server manually. Sometimes it's reported that you have to restart it twice, but usually that's because of the font cache, probably the font cache in .NET framework as well. But it's not a good idea. It's always a good idea just to restart it after it, just to plan that, and you will fine with that. Okay, so you actually now also have the fonts on the server. And the last thing you have to check is, I don't save it now because I didn't make any changes. And if you, for example, created some specific simulation, so I just open it. From the server. Then one disadvantage of changing font types and font sizes could be that actually the text will not fit in the bubble anymore. So always plan this very carefully. I will show you with this example. So you check on every bubble if it still fits, else you right click and do the auto size node. You have to do this anyway. And then you check your content in and then it's ready for publishing. So make sure that if you change your font type, it will not change it automatically. Well, it changes automatically if you open the simulation or the course document in the editor, then it will show the changes. And of course, it will also change when you republish it. So even without checking it in the editor, when you republish your content in uPerform, so I was here in the application training, I add documents to the publishing queue, and in the latest version you can also publish the selected documents now, and then it will be republished, and then you will see new font type in your simulations. Thanks for watching.